Let's talk about a little bit of jargon that you'll hear all the time in instrumental variables analysis. And we'll introduce some ideas that are very helpful in figuring out how do you actually compute treatment effects through an instrumental variables analysis. So remember what a causal effect was defined as in the first place. It's the difference in your outcome when you have the treatment minus your outcome when you don't have the treatment, holding all other relevant variables constant. So the simplest way to obtain causal effects is to just have randomly assigned treatments. Now, random assignment produces variation in treatments directly. You say, this person gets treated, this person doesn't get treated. This person gets treated, this person doesn't get treated. So in the population, there's a bunch of people, some of them are treated and some of them aren't. There's variation in treatments. And that variation in treatment was caused by us, the experimenters. We randomly assigned it, so we produced direct variation. That kind of variation is called exogenous variation. Exo, like exoskeleton, on the outside. That means that it's variation that's unrelated to all the other variables that might affect outcomes. Okay? It's outside of those variables, unrelated to them. Exogenous variation. Now, typically, when we don't have an experiment, then the variation in treatment is going to be endogenous variation, meaning inside or related to the variables that could affect outcomes. This just means that treatments vary across people in some systematic way. So the people who are treated might be different than the people who are untreated, and that's going to be a problem for causal inference. This is just another way of saying that there's unobserved confounders. Now, instrumental variables analysis says that we can learn causal effects by splitting the variation in treatment into two parts, an exogenous part and an endogenous part. So basically, we say, let's think about treatment as an outcome variable itself. There are lots of other variables that would explain a particular person's treatment value, like are they treated or not? Why is one person treated and why is somebody else not treated? One reason is that they have a particular value of the instrument. That's one explanatory variable. It explains why some people are treated. That instrument is randomly assigned by assumption. So the variation in the treatment due to the instrument is exogenous variation. Now, there's some other variables that may also explain why someone has a particular treatment value, whether they're treated or not. Those variables might be endogenous variation because they're systematically related to other variables that might affect the outcome. So we've split the treatment variable into two parts, the endogenous part and the exogenous part. The exogenous part comes from the instrument. So that's why people sometimes say that the instrument provides a source of exogenous variation in the treatment. So to summarize here, the instrumental variables is used when units aren't randomly assigned treatments, but they are randomly assigned to a variable that affects treatments, that partially determines the treatments. That variable is called the instrument.